Hello, my friends. It's me, Karen Valentine, and we are back today to do something a little bit different. I decided to take a break from the portraits that I've been doing and do something a little bit different, if not slightly scary, but not really, because I think it's going to be really, really beautiful after it's all done. So the image is called Death Wisdom, and it is by Sara Richter. I believe it's Sara Richter Art on Etsy. And I just, you know, you see an image and it's like, oh my God, I'm totally going to do that. So this is the light grayscale version. And I actually, before I printed it, I added these butterflies. So the image that you will get from Sara will not have the butterflies, but I just felt like it needed them right there. So I hope you don't mind, but I did add them to my image, and I can either color them on camera, do them last, or I don't know what, but we're going to do the owl first. So we'll worry about the butterflies later. You could also do that if you have Photoshop. I use Photoshop Elements, and it's a great program, and it's only like $99 or something, so it's totally worth it. You can edit your images before you print them. You can lighten the image if it's too dark. You can erase lines that you don't want before you print it, or you can add other things, just like I did. So we are going to do the owl today, and I've been debating on doing this one because, you know, there's a lot more pressure when I'm coloring on camera than there is when I'm just doing it on my own. And this one looked, I just hope I can do it justice. Let's just put it that way. So I'm going to go ahead and zoom in a bit. And let's see, we want to get him kind of right there, I think. I wonder if I should move everything up. No, I guess we'll be okay. All right, so I pulled up an inspiration image on Pinterest. So I had a picture of a great horned owl so that I could have a reference photo. And so I'm just gonna go for it. Editing this one might be difficult because I think I'm going to be switching pencils a lot. But hopefully it'll all work out. Alrighty, so I think I'm going to start with some Deco Yellow. Maybe some, you might want to put some white in there too. Just all right, now I think we'll try Spanish orange. I'm using a pretty light hand right now because I'm not positive about how I want to do the colors, but actually that looks pretty good. See what Sunburst Yellow does. All Okay, there's something about it that's not quite what I want yet. I'm gonna use my white. Let's see if I can show you guys my reference photo here. Let's slide that in. I'm not sure if you'll be able to see it or not. It's really big. Anyway, that's my reference photo for this right now. So I almost feel like it's too bright there or something. I don't know. So I'm going to use light umber and just on the very outer edges. And maybe up the top of the iris. Oh yeah, that's better. Something tells me this is going to be a long video series. this is not going to go real fast. Okay, I think I like that. Let's see, I need my black. Go ahead and do this right here. And heck, we might as well go ahead and darken the pupil. Darken the pupil. Sometimes I use a marker to do pupils because you get such a darker, defined. I might even go over it with marker later. It's so much blacker, you know, when you use a marker. Okay, let's put our white in above his eye. I'm not sure if I want to go. Yeah, I probably should do black over there too. But I want to make sure at least right there is done with the white. All of this is going to be white, but I want some. I think I'm going to put the light umber in first and then let the white blend it and soften it. If that makes sense. Let's see what happens when we put, and I'm wondering if I should get, there's one more color I want to pull out of here. One that's a little bit cooler of a brown, and that would be Sandbar Brown. Sandbar Brown. Let's put a little bit of that in here too. Just going to do some random. Right, now we're going to come in with the white. And the white will also blend the color and soften it, make it look hopefully kind of feathery. Good. Okay, and then right here, this is very white as well, but I'm going to put in the little flecks. It's kind of like the, you know, like the dividing of the fluffy feathers. And then I think I can just, oh, it feels like the camera was really shaking on that one. Just slow down a little bit. So we got that part nailed in. There's going to be some other things that I'm going to want really super white too. I think, well, these are going to be, and this is going to be. So, but I also want to use gray. Thinking out loud, bear with me. Sorry, I moved the camera to the other side of me. So now the tripod is on the right-hand side. We're going to try that as far as to help with lighting and shadows and stuff. But I am right-handed, so it's sort of in my way. So this is kind of going to be an experiment. All right. I'm going to take, oh, I don't know what I'm doing here. Let's take some 50% cool gray. Where do I want that? Why do I want that? I might have gotten ahead of myself. Oh, yeah, down here. Okay, so I'm going to put some of this cool gray. 50% cool gray down here. I just kind of want to make sure I get my white bits established. And white. And then up here, I want to do a little bit of the gray. And a little bit of the sandbar brown. Maybe right here. then white in here. Okay. Maybe a little bit more Sandbar Brown. And I'm just flicking my pencil. Okay. How about we do around the eyes? So I'm going to put some white down first. Right around the eye, and then I'm going to go over it with another color. So a little bit of white. And then we're going to try Seashell Pink. So I want it very light, but I don't want it white. So that, but my reference photo, this area up here is quite white, so I'm going to leave that. But the Seashell Pink is going to darken that white just enough, I think. Okay, then, now this beige sienna that I have is awfully small. I'm gonna see if I have another one in my book. Well, we'll try it, and if I cover up too much of what I'm doing, I'll go get a new pencil. That was the other reason I moved the camera to the other side. I think I won't cover up what I'm doing as much. Okay, so we're going to flick normally. I say don't do lines, do little circles, but in this case we want lines. Let me get in here. Okay, let's do the other side. Going to use light umber. Zoomed in enough. I'm going to zoom in a little bit more. All debating on using a little bit more, a little darker color in there too. So let's try some espresso. Just a tiny bit. And then I'm gonna take my my white. And I'm basically, oh, I just broke my double pencil. Boy, that's really zoomed in. My hands look really, really big. And I'm basically going into that area that I had white in. And I'm just kind of pulling out. And it's sort of blending the colors, but not really. But it's softening things and making it look fluffier, if that makes sense. Okay, so the next color on the outside, I think will be espresso, and maybe even some black. So let's do that. I'm only thinking because, you know, the reference photo is different than the drawn photo. So you kind of have to work your way through and find a happy medium between the two. So this pencil is too small for me to be comfortable with, so I need to see if I have another one. Yes, I do. Okay, what are we doing next? Debating. Let's zoom out just a little bit. Oh, sorry guys. Okay, we're just gonna keep going. Have to tackle this part, but I'm not quite sure what I'm going to do yet, so I'm just going to go and do the ears. This is my black. You guys can use regular Prismacolor black. if you don't have this pencil, but I do love my Schpirerr Farben Black pencil. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and add some black here. Even though it's not on my reference photo, I think that will be just fine. And it actually kind of gives him a slightly more ominous look. So that's all right. And then okay, so his head, the top of his head has quite a stripy look in my reference photo. So I'm going to try and duplicate that as best I can. I need to get a longer white now. Okay, so for that we're going to use white, black, and maybe, I'm not sure if I should use the Seashell Pink or the Light Umber. No, I mean the beige, maybe, let's see. Beige Sienna, maybe? Alright, let me see what this... Yeah, probably beige sienna. All right, so first I'm going to put some white in. I have no idea if I'm... Really, I'm winging this, guys, so I hope it comes out okay. Plus, this is the light, the light grayscale, which I like because the lines are not dark and I can have a little bit more freedom. But on the other hand, I can't really see what I'm doing, so I can only hope that it's right. This is Beige Sienna. Can you see? Yeah, that's good. And maybe we'll just... Yeah, I don't... I hope this turns out okay. It may be when we put the black in that the stripes really start to show. But I need to get a longer pencil. I need, this one's too short for me. So I'll be right back.
Okay.
So I was very lucky, I guess, that there was an art supply store near my house. Not lucky that it closed, because that stunk, because I loved to be able to go in there and get my open stock pencils whenever I wanted to, because they were cheaper, much cheaper than even getting them at like Michael's or Hobby Lobby or any of those places. But they closed down their store that was closest to me. And when they did that, they put all of their supplies on sale. And so I went in and got Prismacolors for like half price. And I just bought as many of them as I could get. I think I only paid like a dollar. I don't know, a dollar, maybe a little over a dollar a piece for them. That was wonderful. So I have a stash of new ones when I need them. Let's see. Before I keep going, I think I want to get the top of his ears in with my other colors. So I'm going to put some white in. You can't even see it. It's literally, I mean, seriously, I can't even see it. But, and then the Beige Sienna. I kind of want to see where the top of his head is. So. guess we can go back to our black. Beige Sienna. And I have no idea if blending this with white is a good idea or a bad idea. So I'm just gonna do it in small little bits. Cause I don't really want to blend, but I want to blur. If that makes sense. Now in my reference photo, this is even darker. So I'm wondering if I should go back and add a little bit more black. That looks a little better. Okay, we're gonna zoom. All right, and then it should be kind of the same look out here. Stripey sort of, so I'll do the same thing. I think I'll do Beige Sienna first this time. And zoom in again. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and put some white in. Although maybe I should do that after. I'll do black. Far so good, I think. Beige Sienna. Okay, part of me wants to add a little bit more of this up here too, though. Let's work on the beak. So I have several cool grays that I've pulled out here. Oh, good grief. I'm gonna have to find a different place to keep my pencils. Let's try that. Okay, so I want to put down some... I need a regular pencil. Do I have a regular pencil? I guess I could use a black. So in my reference photo, there's a little line, and it might actually be there in the darker version, but in this lighter version, it was so light that I'm gonna draw that in. Because I think that's supposed to be there. All right, let's put some white. Right there. A little bit right up the center. And then we'll do 30% cool gray. And then 70% cool gray. Just keep going. So the top of his beak right here, we're gonna do white. And then the bottom of his beak, oh, this is 90% cool gray. And then maybe 50%. Nope, this is 70% cool gray. I wanna flick around here because I wanna preserve the look of the feathers kind of going over the beak, if that makes sense. Okay, and then I think I'm going to try blending up I want a little bit more. So this is 10% cool gray. Then I want some brown, so let's try light umber. And maybe black, again, just right on the I feel like I got his beak shaped funny. Something about it is bugging me. But I don't know what that is. So this is my Prisma blender because I can get it. I can get it so sharp. Works. I like it so far. He's good. Okay. Do we keep going? Let's see. His feathers down here, and then underneath those feathers, I think that's the, that's part of the skull. So I don't want to do too much with that yet, because I'm not sure what color I'm gonna do it. So I'm just gonna put a few darker feathers with this 70% cool gray. And what do we need to do? We need to do something right there. So I'm gonna take, I'll start with light umber. My hand just looks so humongous. I feel like I need to keep it out of frame. And then this is espresso. You guys don't need to be seeing my bad manicure that close up. Okay, I think I'm gonna define this just by doing that. Okay, feathers. Wing feathers, I think, would be next. So I'm going to zoom out a little bit. Maybe all the way to regular. So that's where we're at so far. Looks pretty good. So for the feathers, I think we'll start by putting the black in, and then we'll put everything else in on top. So let me zoom in again. And gosh, I almost feel like I want to start at the bottom and work my way up, just because I can see where the color is supposed to go. So I'm going to do that. So is that the direction that I want the lines to go, straight down, or do I want them to go side to side? Because, well, we'll just, I guess we'll do straight down. There's a lot of feathers here. So, in the interest of not having this video be 3 hours long, I think I'm going to stop the video. I'm going to literally just be putting these stripey over, pretty much over the lines that Sara's already drawn, other than there's some areas here where the lines are really, really light. But I think you can, you know, you can see them if you're doing the light version. And if not, you can just put in your own. So I'm going to do all the black over the feathers, and not, I won't do these feathers down here, just the top feathers, just these. And I'll do that and then I will come back. Okay, see you in a few minutes. Okay, I am back. And I have added my black to the feathers. And I'm gonna cross my fingers and hope that these turn out. I just don't know. So we'll see. I mean, the head turned out okay, right? So all right, so as far as the feathers go, I felt like the beige sienna wasn't warm enough. So I'm going to try and warm it up with this. I keep calling it sable, but it's actually sand. For some reason, I'm calling the, this is the only one I do that to. But anyway, so the reason, the way that I came about this color combo is that I also felt like this area here wasn't warm enough. So I pulled out this sand slash sable. I'm probably always going to call it sable. And I really liked the way that looked a lot better. So we're going to add this number 940 sand slash sable to that area right there. And it just, I like it. I like it better. So I think that's the color that we're going to use in the feathers too. So away we go. I guess I'll start at the top. I don't know. I think what's going to wind up happening is I'm going to go through and do these, and then I'll come in with black again and add the shading shadows to the feathers that will help define them a little bit more. I hope that's right. I think it will be. I think it'll be good. And out here, I think we'll just try something like that. I think the hardest part is going to be to really get the shadows in here and still have feather definition.
Yes, that sigh was for once again being out of frame. I'm sorry. There's some work to be done here behind this scrolly thing, but I'm not ready to do it yet. I think it'll be easier for me once I actually color that scrolly thing so I can see what I'm doing. I can't just put this in there for now. Okay. So in her design, a lot of these shorter feathers are not a double, don't have a double black line. But feel like some of them I want to add that to, so I'm just gonna do that. I'm not crazy about how it looks right now, but well, granted it's early yet, but I suspect these are going to be harder than I think. Okay, so I'm going to add this sand / sable color. I'm just going over the whole thing because I don't mind if the black gets a little blurry. Question then becomes, do I just fill all these areas in with black? And if I do that, what's going to happen to the definition of my feathers? I don't know the answer to that. So for this part, I think I'm going to use my Prisma Black, which I don't have out. Okay, let's say a little prayer. Oh, I don't know. I'm going to zoom in, but okay, so you got to treat them like you would treat any other feather or any other scales. So I just need to suck it up and go for it. The problem is that I chose, you know, maybe that's the problem. Maybe I need to add some espresso. Just checking to see. That might help to define the shadows from the... I'm gonna just do that real quick. Let's... I'm just going to add, and I don't, I know I'm babbling. I'm sorry. That's what happens when I'm thinking and I'm not sure about what I'm doing. My thoughts just spill out of my brain. Okay. So I kind of like the addition of the espresso. I don't think it would have been dark enough if I had just done straight espresso and no black underneath. So I don't think we wasted time doing the black first. We're just gonna do it. Just shut up and do it. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna completely lose definition. Dang, I'm not gonna be happy with this. I'm not happy. All right, I have to figure out how to fix this. Don't follow me. I don't know how I'm going to fix this, because I don't like it. So... I'm going to go through and... Seriously, I don't know what I'm doing here. I'm just going to try defining the feathers. Oh, I'm so disappointed in myself. Okay. I'm going to shut up and just work. And hope that I can pull it off in the end. Okay, well, I don't hate it. Hopefully I can duplicate it on the other side. And I think once the whole thing is done and we get these feathers and these feathers done, I think it'll be okay. I'm just wondering if I take some white. Sometimes when I do feathers, yeah, I use white to pull the color through the feather. And it helps to make it look more feather-like for some reason. Okay, I think I can live with that. Question is, can we duplicate it? I think we can. So, I believe we did. Espresso over the top of the black. We may have to break this owl up into two parts just to keep the video at about 2 hours. I use light umber or beige sienna for the combo. That's terrible. I can't even remember. Oh my goodness. What did we do? Beige sienna and sable. Yeah, that looks right. Light umber would have been too dark. So, beige sienna. think I went through with black and kind of gave some of these some feathery definition here. Yes, I did. I think it'll be okay. this. Now I'm all paranoid about it, what I'm calling it. Sand, Sable. From henceforth, I'm dubbing this color Sable. So don't get confused.
Okay, and now a little bit of... you know what I want to put? Just one more. Zoom in a little bit so you can see what. They're not, you know, perfectly defined feathers, but I think they look okay. Once everything else gets done, I think they'll be good. I think we have time to do a little bit more. So I think I'll go ahead and do these feathers and we'll see how it goes. So I'm gonna put the light in this time first.
I don't know why, just because. See how this is gonna work. Let's see, that's light umber. Where's my espresso? Right here. Okay, let's put the yellow in. Sorry, not yellow. Sable. Okay, and I'm just gonna go straight to espresso, and we can always darken later. And this will probably all be dark, like black, I would imagine. We'll darken that up, probably. I guess it looks okay. I'm not sure what it's. There's a lot more than just, you know, black and not black, but dark brown. It looks like there's this whole variation of color here. So I don't know what to do. This is white. No, I I need to add some more dark first. Maybe. Nope, that's not what I want. This is what I want. Maybe I will add a little bit of black. We'll let the black and the espresso kind of see, there I go, not finishing a thought again. I'll keep them kind of separate. Let's see how that goes. Can always add more. I think I better do another one before I pass judgment on whether I like this or not. Let me get out a reference photo here. Okay, so looks like we should have, I'm gonna leave that because I really don't have a choice. Let's see. Let's do the light colors in here. I think that's where we made our mistake on this first one was that I didn't put I got lost in thought again. I didn't put the dark in between the light very well, so just ignore me. Put the video on mute. This. And my espresso. Do a little bit of dark in here. I want to put a line right there, and while I'm thinking of it, I'm going to do it on that one too. I missed it over there, so we'll just let it be. Beige Sienna. back to Espresso. All this is going to be black, I think, or very, very dark. This here is okay. So let's see what happens if I do my white pencil trick. Though some of the areas I don't think are dark enough to really, I'm going to darken this. I didn't darken that enough. I'm going to darken that later with some black. Okay, so I kind of like how the white pencil just, it kind of blurs everything. Try and do this so that I can preserve the fuzzy look of the feet there. Come in and zoom a little bit more. And I'll darken this. This is probably going to be, I don't know, maybe I'm going to come up here and do brown or espresso, sorry. And then black. This is all going to be blacker. I'll go over it again, either with more black or espresso to, but at least I can get a feel for it better this way. I'm gonna This is one of the hardest pieces I've done. Back to black. This probably isn't. This isn't right. It's not right. I don't know what to do.
I'm determined.
All right. So. Just gonna still not right. Shouldn't have that. Shouldn't have to have that.
Sorry.
Not feeling very good about this. Although, you know, after everything else gets done, it'll probably look better. And maybe it, I feel like maybe it needs some more black. Maybe that's part of my problem. It's not perfect, but then neither am I, so I think I'm gonna have to let that be. Although part, I think I want to darken. I think that needs to be darker so that those top feathers show. So yeah, that's better. I think that's better. Which means this should probably be darker too. Okay. I'm not sure if I can duplicate that over on the other side, but we'll try. Let's see, I'm gonna get rid of some of these pencils. Make sure you're in frame here. Alrighty. I think we're gonna finish this wing and then probably stop the video. I think we'll probably be well over 2 hours. What's next? Espresso. I'm going to zoom just a little bit. Zoom out. Okay. This is all going to get done in black. Fading to black, I guess. think I'll save that for some black. I don't know, these bottom feathers threw me for a loop because they weren't, they had all kinds of other crazy kind of designs in them. I didn't know it. I can do this. I'm determined. Black. I've lost my my kind of visual of where that's kind of wanted them to be sort of symmetrical. But I'm not going to be able to do that, so we'll just brown, but I think I would rather have some. Well, I went out too far on that one. That was okay. Do I just do some blending? Oi. This is black. That looks a little bit better there, and then I have to color in all that. Let's go ahead and do the white, blurring the lines of everything, which, oh yeah, I wanted to put some black in there. Okay, so black, in here. And did I ever put the Sable in? This is the Sable. Let's go ahead and darken this. And this all got in black. More espresso. Okay, and then we'll take our black. This is not how the artist, I think, intended these feathers to look, but that's okay. The only way I could get them to work for me, so be it. I'm gonna do a little more dark over the, yeah, a little more espresso over the top of where I smeared it with the white. Okay. I think I blended this. Needs And I think I'm just gonna soften. Yeah, just soften these, this thing that I did. There, that's better. Okay, this needs a little bit of that. A little bit more black. There. Let's see, this I want to do a little bit darker.
Let me zoom out. Oh, there we go. So it's not too bad. I don't dislike it, and I suspect that as I keep going and I get the feet in and I get all this done and the rest of the more feathers, I think I'll keep liking it better and better. All right, guys, that's it for part one. We'll keep going on part two, and hopefully we'll get it done. My favorite part's the face. I think the face came out pretty good. I'm pretty happy with that. All right, so I will see you all on part two. Thank you so much. Bye.